and hit it first time, and it was in the bottom corner. Great feeling.
Not scored many better ones than that.
Well, I never scored in the cup. They was only saying that today. That was my first cup goal this year, and what a time to score one.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Well, we played against West Ham when I was at United the Tuesday or Wednesday before the FA Cup final when we played Liverpool. And a lot of people can't remember this. I remember when I had to go back. I always used to pick the centre-halves up at Man United, even though I'm only 5'9". I used to pick the biggest up because I was strong. We used to batter each other. And I was picking Pop Robson up. So we went up for the ball. And I headed it, and it went in the top corner, and Pop claimed it. So I got him back. I said, "That wasn't you. I did that." He said, "Ah, I'm claiming it, though." And I scored a goal that night from about 35, 40 yards. The ball came out, and I hit this dip volley, and it went so high that I think everybody lost it in the lights, and it dipped into the top corner. It's one of the best goals I've ever scored. And nobody seemed to acknowledge it. In the papers the next day, they all thought it was a fluke. And just so annoying. But it was great there. We it's difficult playing in a midweek game before a cup final on a Saturday. And I can understand why people say they're thinking more of the cup final, because you probably were deep down. And nobody wanted to get injured. So when Billy's come rushing at you, you know, you might jump out the way. So, that was the only time I remember really playing against West Ham. But I loved going to the stadium. I remember playing against Tommy Taylor once at Upton Park. I'll give him a bit of a torrid time. And I think that would have been the game John Lyle might have been looking at saying, "Oh, I wouldn't mind Pancho in the team," because I was pretty fit then, great in the air, doing things that a good centre-forward would do. And it was only when I had all these knee operations that you can't do certain things. But now to play against West Ham, because you always know it's going to be a football game. You know, I know Billy's got a reputation, but he was a fair lad. He'd kick you, pick you up, then I'd kick him, he'd laugh at you, and then you'd get on with it. You know, it's a good game of football. And we both teams wanted to play good, attractive, attacking football, and that's what the fans got, so they loved it as well. Players loved it. Everybody's happy.
But Stuart was a big game player. He was an international. He played 20-odd games for England, you know, and he used to play at Wembley. He was a big game player, Stuart.
Neil making an extra match. He's run well, too. Couple to help. 3-0 in the box. Fifth. And it's in! Really nice build-up that by England. Fifth. The score.
Well, the season 79, it was a nightmare for me at Man United. So I had three operations on my knee. Every time I went in, took 3 months to get right again, started playing again, something wrong with my knee. So I missed the full season. I played 2 cup games. Each time I got carried off with my knee. And we think they'd done it right, the last operation I had. So I'm training again. Man United are playing Arsenal. I know we lost 3-2, but I was on the bench. Not on the bench. I wasn't fit enough to be on the bench, but I sat with the lads, and that was disappointing. But the whole season was a nightmare for me. And then I got annoyed at them because they were on about giving me a one-year contract because they didn't know how fit I'd be. And it just wasn't right what they did to me. So I told Sexton I didn't want to stay. I was going to move. And John Lyle came to see me, and it all went from there. Tremendous guy. Really impressed with him. He knew what he wanted. He rang me and he said, "Look, we want to sign you. Would you be interested?" I said, "Yeah, of course I would." He said, "I'll come and see you." He came to my house. I was still in Sale in Manchester, and They spent a couple of hours there. And he never rushed anything, John. He was, but I just, there's a calmness about him. And he told me what he wanted, his visions for the club. He just wanted a good attacking team. And he told me the players, which I knew who he'd already had. And I just kind of fell in love with him a bit. You know, he was just amazing. And then when I joined the club, his coaching and that was different class. Because me, in football, I never did it for the money. There wasn't a lot of money in the game as it was, but my motivations was to play football for Man United at the time. Just loved it. And the same thing was going to happen with West Ham. I wasn't really that interested in the money side of it. So when I saw John, he offered me a decent wage and I said yes straight away. So I met everybody at the ground. John was very friendly with all the backroom staff and the ladies at the ground. They all make you a cup of tea, make you very happy in the offices there. So that was good. It makes you feel at home straight away. The only nightmare I was going to have is staying at a hotel for a bit because I was married. And I stayed in Epping, which was great. So I used to go on a Monday night and then leave straight after a game. So it wasn't ideal until we got a house in Shenfield. My wife came over. We kept the house in Manchester and moved all the furniture in. So we'd stay all season, go back in the summer to sort the house out, and then get a removal wagon back to London again the next year. I did that for 2 years, and then Sue said, oh, I've had enough of all this. So I had to go back and try and get some digs. And I was in digs for the last year I was at West Ham, which was fantastic, really. I mean, they really looked after us. There's a few of the lads there staying with them. And no, it was fantastic. But, you know, if you're not happy with your home life, you'd struggle anyhow, you know.
Devonshire. Pearson!
Stuart Pearson's first goal for West Ham following his signing from Manchester United was his 100th in league football.
What are your memories of Upton Park?
Ah, oh, amazing. Sometimes when the crowd gets on your side and the cheering you, and it's just like being next to you on the wing, you know. They loved the team. They used to chant all the time. The atmosphere was fantastic, and I just thought it helped the home team. It helped West Ham because a lot of the opposition used to freeze a little bit coming down that tunnel, and then you'd see everybody on top of you. And the team was that good at the time that we could beat anybody on the day. And if everybody's at it and the tactics are right, which John always seemed to have it right, and you need a little bit of luck in front of goal. And if ever you do struggle and you bring them back to Upton Park, we always knew we were going to beat them because it was the atmosphere was always fantastic there.
Later that season, he was to score a more important one, as Match of the Day featured the Hammers in the FA Cup semi-final.
You look through it and you think, yeah, we beat Villa, we beat Orient, we beat Swansea, we beat... Yeah, and then we drew with so-and-so, and you think, oh, I forgot about that game. You tell you, it's that long ago, nearly 40 years, that you forget these things. And those are the important games. You've got to beat them.
20 minutes to go. West Ham a goal down, but still coming forward. And don't forget, they're playing against 10 men. Brooking is in space here. Pearson in the centre. Pearson's coming in! It's there! Pearson, near post!
He crossed it near post. And I just got in front of the two centre-backs and put it in the corner. I was just delighted there. The problem is, me, with my goal celebrations, I never look at the crowd and then do it. I just do it. And when I stood there with my fist up like that, the Everton fans were about 2 yards away from me. And they all tried to get me and drag me in. I think I'd have ended up in a bit of a state if they'd have got me. But I didn't do it to wind them up. It was just my celebrations. I was just that happy. It went up and I'm going, yeah. And I think sometimes they think that you're doing it to wind them up. But I'd never, ever do that because I don't like those sort of things. But great occasion that was, because you know that you're playing... a replay and against a good team like Everton, you know. So, but everyone looked at us and went, "Oh yeah, they're in the second division. You know, we'll beat them." But they didn't realise how good a team we were.
Looking again, that so important look up, Devonshire. Pearson, Devonshire, he's in the gap. Can he put it in? He can! Oh, that's a brilliant goal! That is a marvellous goal!
Well, the replay again, I thought we were fantastic. And when I think everyone remembers the Lampard celebration running around the goal post, corner flag.
Lampard! Frank Lampard has scored for West Ham!
There's loads of crowds about, you're all excited, and I'd had a bit of a neck, and I had to let John know on the Thursday whether I was going to be fit or not, so I said I was fit, and I hadn't trained most of that week because of this sore neck, and I had to have a cortisone in my neck before the game. With Rob the physio, I'm in the dressing room area, and the injection comes out, and I think Dev walked in and he felt ill afterwards, so he saw it going in my neck, and it just stopped me from feeling my neck. So when I'm going out on the pitch, I'm fully fit, so that was great. But the game went fantastic. I mean, John just told us before the game his plan. He told everybody together. He said, "I want you to, Pancho," we didn't even work on it in training. He said, "Pancho, I want you to drop a little bit deeper, so midfield players don't know whether to pick you up, or the centre-backs don't." And that's exactly what happened. After 10 minutes, Talbot was shouting over to Terry Neal, you know, who's going to pick him up? And is it us or Willie Young or O'Leary? So I don't think Terry Neal even knew, so they just left it. And then it was worse for them, because I probably caused them more damage than we even thought would happen. I was getting balls, knocking it out wide to Dev.
Pearson, who made the earlier move. Devonshire. Oh, Devonshire's round the back. Oh, right across, it's free. Driven in, and is it a goal? It is. Brooking. Trevor Brooking. The ball ricocheted in off him, and West Ham are in front. Alan Devonshire made it possible. The ball over to the far side of the goal.
Well, I was obviously in the box. The ball bounced to me. I had a snapshot. It was probably, if I'm being honest, it was going to hit the corner flag. And I joke with Trevor all the time about it hit him on the head and flew in the top corner. But Trevor said he saw it and headed it in the corner. It was a fantastic header for somebody who never gets any headers. It was fantastic for Trevor because he had a great game. Him and Billy are Mr. West Ham. Everybody loves them to bits. They're both fantastic people. They're both fantastic players. And to have them two in the team, it was amazing. And I'm just glad they both did great on the day, which I thought every one of us earned our medal that day. I thought we were brilliant. I think everybody on that pitch, Crossy's moaned that he only touched the ball about half a dozen times. But, I mean, you would substitute that for a win any day. He worked hard. He was a thorn in their side. He battered them. He did everything right. But sometimes when you play at Wembley, you just want to feel as though you've played great. Trevor was super, and I thought I had a decent game as well. So you win 1-0, but you like to play well, and everybody did do. So it was a great day for everybody. And after the game, all I ever did saw myself just picking the medal up and kissing it. That's all I was doing while the photographs and the films were rolling on the pitch. And I was in shock, really, I think, because I didn't realise we'd beat them. I think everybody thought they were favourites. And it was just another fantastic day in my 3 years I was at West Ham. We had a fantastic night, signing loads of things, champagne. And afterwards, me, Frank Lampard and a few of the lads went out somewhere else and on it again. So we're a bit worse for wear for the coach ride the next day. That was amazing, seeing all those fans, you know. I mean, we all knew they were special anyhow, the fans. But to see what we did on the day going around London, it was just amazing, you know, even though it was, you had one eye shut from the night before. But it was just nice to see that even though we were in the second division, the fans had supported us all that year. And because we didn't get promotion till the next year. And we just looked a super team. And we just wanted to give something back to the fans. And I think we did it. And they were all delighted.
Well, two lads with me in their first season with West Ham. What a way to finish the season, eh?
Tremendous. Tremendous to get the cup. Bring it back and all these fans. It's tremendous.
What's it been like along the route, Stuart? You've got, of course, something to compare it with Manchester United.
That's right. I think the route took a little bit longer this time to get here, and I think there was more fans on the route, but in Manchester, at the town hall, there's usually about 250,000 people there, but this, I think there's more people turned out to greet us today. It's been fantastic. I mean, look at them now. I mean, they're unbelievable.
With me doing it before, like 76, 77, 79, what I didn't want to do was be that much in the limelight. So everybody's looking at it on the telly saying, oh, there's Pancho, he's leading it all. I tried to let them enjoy it a bit more, me stay in the background a little bit. So it worked for me, and but it was nice to see Ollie's of this world enjoying himself, and most of the lads did anyhow. The actual fans, they love the club, they do anything for them, and all they want is a little bit of success. That's all they've strived for all these years. They're very loyal, and yeah, that's all they want. And that's what they wanted from us, and that's what they got. There ain't a crowd in sight. Out of all the years I was there 3 years. I didn't play as many games as I should have done. But my main regret was always, I'd have loved to have played in that team when I was as fit as I was at Man United, and when I was an England player, when I used to be able to beat anybody for pace. I used to come in with my goals. I was never a David Cross. I'd never get you 30 goals a year, but I'd get you 15 to 20. And that was my biggest regret, being at West Ham, not being fit enough to be able to do what I used to be able to do. In those days, you could do that. They'd leave one on you, and he's kicking the ball down the channels, and you'd leave your foot there. So it's tit for tat. If they can't take a good smack around the ear or an elbow on the nose, they shouldn't be playing. And that's the way we're playing. You can't do it nowadays. If you got somebody back nowadays, you'll get sent off. And I don't like all this video stuff in the box where they're keeping an eye on everything. The strong will survive. And if I'm playing against a big centre-half and he's stronger than me and he's pushing me out the way and I let him do it, he deserves to win it. So that's the way I usually play.